Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to another class, another day. Today we'll do some science and occupation. So for today in science, we have something brand new to start with. So it's hopefully nice and exciting, something new that we haven't done before. So I want all of you to pay attention. And if you have any questions, please raise your hand and ask them. So we're going to look at conservation as a whole. We're going to look at conservation and how do we take care of all the living things. Remember, for us, we are also part of living things. So we always take part of ourselves and take care of ourselves by eating the healthy foods or going for some exercise. We also conserve our bodies. But we also have the power to take care of a lot of different types of living organisms around us. So in this topic, we're going to look at how we can take care of them. So our first word for the day that we're going to learn at the bottom left is albinism. Albinism. All together, say albinism.
Albinism.
Very good, very good. Albinism is a skin defect. It's when you are born with a skin defect. So usually this occurs more frequently in black people. So black people get born with a pinkish skin. It's called an albino. Albinism is when they have a different color skin than they should have. Okay. The next one here is a chromosome. All together, chromosome.
Chromosome.
Neck is the four. Let's station. Neck is the group. Neck fibrous.
Fibrous root. Very good, Tantan. So yes, the chromosome, we'll look at the chromosome in the lesson itself as well. It is part of our DNA. It's what makes us who we are. And the next word we have is deforestation. All together, deforestation.
Deforestation.
Excellent. And the next one we have is an ethnic group.
Ethnic group.
Ethnic group.
Now, what is the ethnic group?
Fibrous root.
Yes, we get to the fibrous root now. But just quickly, from the ethnic group, it is where you are from. So, for the ethnic group, for you guys are mainly Thai. Your ethnicity is Thai. My ethnic group is South African. Okay. And the last one we have is fibrous root.
Fibrous root.
The fibrous root is also a part of the root system.
Next, we'll have genetic inheritance. Next, genetic variation. Next, mangrove swamp. Next, taproot. Next, wildlife.
Very good, Tantan. Very good. But let's do them all together. Genetic inheritance. All together. Genetic inheritance.
Genetic.
Now, genetic inheritance is qualities that you receive from birth, from your mother and father. So a lot of people might say you have your mother's nose, it's part of genetics, or you have your father's eyes, or you look more like your father, or you look more like your mother. That is part of our genetic
inheritance. Next is genetic variation.
Yes, next is genetic variation. Altogether, genetic variation.
Genetic variation.
Genetic variation.
So that is when, let's say you grow, just a moment, Tanta, just a moment. Genetic variation is when you have the same plant, but different outcomes. So you, let's say you have apple plants. You have a few apple trees. Some of the apples are green, some of them are red, and some of them are yellow. There is a variation in genetics that make them different. They are all apple plants, but they're all a little bit different because one has green apples, one red apples, one yellow apples. Okay, our next one is our mangrove swamp.
Mangrove swamp.
Excellent, very good. Now, mangrove swamp is something you will find south of Thailand, on the islands, especially close to Krabi. There is a big mangrove forest close to the ocean there, which forms mangrove swamps. The next one we have is taproot.
Taproot.
Now, the taproot is the main root of the plant. It is like the plant's heart. The main one, the first one to grow is the taproot. And that's the one that grows very deep to find all the water.
Like it's the main root and the other root will grow from that one.
Yes, very good, Tantan. That is correct. Yes, that is the main root. And the other ones grow from it. And the last one is wildlife.
It's like wild thing.
Yes, like wild things. Like if you see some birds or some monkeys, or maybe you see an elephant.
Monkey.
You can see they're part of wildlife. Yes. Very good. So today we're going to focus a little bit more on our genetic inheritance or our hereditary characteristics. Some very big words. Ooh, teacher, these science words, they are so big. Yes, they are very big because they talk about very important things. So first of all, let's look at the picture at the bottom. We have two parents here. We have the mother here and we have the father. Okay, so now we have two different people with two different sets of DNA. So what happens if they have children? The children gets some of the genetics. So 50% of the father's genetics and 50% of the mother's genetics gets transferred to the children. So in that case, that is 100%. But of that 100%, 25% will not do anything. 50% of them will be half. You either get your mom or your dad, 50% from them. And then at the end, the rest from the other one, you get 25%. So if you get 50% from your mom, you only get 25% from your dad, which means, let's say your dad is a very tall man and your mom is very short. If you have 50% of your dad's trait, then you will also be tall. You can also be tall. But if you have 50% of your mom's trait, you might be shorter. So we can see that with stuff like eyes. I have bad eyes. Those are genetic. I got bad eyes from my parents' side. Some people are born fat. Some families are all very fat. It's just genetics. They struggle to lose weight. They are just more fat. And some people are very skinny. And the whole family is super skinny. It's because of their genetics. Genetics change a lot of things. It also to do with some diseases. Like if you are small, some kids might get smallpox, some might not. Can also be genetic. Oh, some people have blue eyes, some people have green eyes, some people have brown eyes. Those all come from our parents, the color of our eyes. So we have to say thank you for our parents for making us look so beautiful. Because most of the way that we look comes from our parents, or certain aspects come from our parents. Only 25% is our own. It's made up completely out of us. Okay, very interesting things here. So let's quickly look at the hereditary characteristics and the genetic inheritance. If you want to follow along, it is on page 122, if you want to follow along. So firstly, genetic inheritance means the passing of certain characteristics such as eye color, hair color, and height from parents to their children. So your parents...
Oh, it's...
Yes, Tanta?
It's like when we born, we have a chance that we will tall like father or short like mother.
Yes. Yes, it's because of our mother and father determine, are we going to be tall or short? Are we going to be fat or thin? Are we going to have curly hair or straight hair? Are we going to have a big nose or a small nose? Big eyes, small eyes. So a lot of that comes from our parents. So if we read here, other characteristics or traits that can pass on to offspring, such as body size, height, skin color, hair color, and eyelid type. For example, if you have two people from the same color, and they also make babies, the chance of having a different color baby is very low. It's very low. And also some people like me, if you look at my thumb, is straight. Some people have a bend, a bit of a curve in the thumb, a curved thumb. So a lot of these are coming from our parents. So here is some examples we can look at quickly to run through them about what are the types of traits that we can inherit. So the first one here is fatness or thinness. Some people are just bigger than other people. It can be because they're bigger bones or they are just genetically different. You get also tallness and shortness. So some of us in the class is tall, some are a bit shorter. Everyone is a little different. Some have curly hair, some have straight hair. In Thailand, I mostly see people with straight hair. Maybe because they use certain things to help them make it straight. Here we have like the widow's peak. So this is about our nose. Some people have a pointy nose like this. Some people have a nose that is nice and flat to their face. Some have single eyelids. Some have double eyelids. You can roll your tongue like this. Some people can do that. Some people cannot do that. If you want to try, you can try doing this. Roll your tongue like this. Some people can do it, some people cannot. And others, you can roll like this as well. Roll it different ways or close it together. That is genetic. I always thought everyone can roll their tongue until I saw a lot of people that cannot do it. Hey, some people have dimples. Now, dimples, if you smile, it causes little indentations here. So that is dimples and no dimples. And a straight thumb and a curved thumb. Now, these are just some examples of different genetic inheritance traits that we can get from our parents. It's not to say we'll get all of it from them, but we can. Now, what causes the genetic inheritance? It's caused by our genes. Now, if you look at the picture on the left here, it is a picture of the genes. And that is made up of our DNA. So this is the gene. I'll draw another picture here. So you can see this picture here is the gene. All of us have this complex gene system inside us. So some of us genes might be different. Some might be moving this way, some this way, but we all have genes. It's not the gene that you wear to the night market. No, not that gene, no. It is inside you. It is your genetic makeup, what you are made of. So you are put together by a bunch of genes. Now the genes are located and set also on a chromosome. So if you look at the gene itself, there's a lot of chromosomes there. And the picture on the left and on the right here shows us how does a chromosome look like. Now this chromosome are X and Y chromosomes. Now they change certain things about us. If you have one less chromosome, then you might be Down syndrome, have Down syndrome, or might have a form of autism. So our chromosomes can also determine certain birth defects. People that are born without an arm, or people that are born with no legs. These are all certain things that can happen through our genetic inheritance. Okay. Ooh, are we all still awake? Yes, we are. Yes, we are. Let's hope so. Let's hope all of us are still awake and with us. Aha. Let's quickly look at an example where you guys can also talk to me now. Write the correct answer. Compare your cat characteristics with your parents and write the answer in the table. Okay. So let's get some examples. Who can tell me what characteristic do you have of your father? What characteristic do you have of your father? Who can tell me? Who's going to try? I'll give you one example. In my instance, with my dad lost his hair on top of his head, and I am also losing my hair on top of my head. So that is something I inherited from him. Okay, that's something I inherited from him. What else can you inherit from your father? Who can tell me? Give me any example. What can you inherit or get from your father? What characteristic? What about your weight? You can get your weight or your body built from your father. You can also get the same from your mother. What else? What other characteristics can we get? We just looked at them on this page here. We looked at all of them here. So give me some examples, What do we think? Anyone?
Tall.
So I'm gonna just use the word height. Yes. Height being tall, you can get from your father. You can also get that from your mother as well. Tall and short. You can get both of them from your mother and father, being tall or being short. What else? What else can we get? What do you think? What about our eyes? What about our eyes? What can we get from our parents? What about our eyes? Look at the eyes. What can we get from our eyes? How about the size of the eyes? Yes. The size of our eyes. But what is the main thing about the eye? Is the... Start with a C. What? Color. Our color. What else? What else? I want some more examples. We have a lot of them in the book there. You just have to read them. Let's get some more examples here, please. Come on, anyone, come on, come on. Let's hear some answers. What are the some of the traits or characteristics that we can get from our parents? Let's get a couple of them. Okay. So it doesn't seem that we're going to answer that question. Let's read at the bottom here. Let's read at the bottom. All together, let's listen. Let's listen. Parents can pass on their observable inherited human traits, which means they can pass on some characteristic to us. So like I say, our eye color, the form of your mouth, maybe your height, if you are big or small, is all part of our observable inherited human traits. And they pass it to the offspring. So they give us examples, height, skin color, hair color, and some other human traits. That have been passed from a grandparents too. So what happens is you have your grandparents give some of the genes to your parents. Your parents have kids, they give it to the children. And then the children to the grandchildren. And so the traits and characteristics are passed on from generation to generation. That's also why we also have, for men, we have to keep our surname, to keep that line of descendants going. So if you have one surname and you keep it...
I don't know what to answer.
Okay, I will ask another question now. We'll go past this one. Let me just zoom out again until we get here. Okay, so for this picture here, what happens is the grandparents have children. The children get some information from their parents. And the parents then meet and they give it to the children. And so it carries on. So that means we call that genetic diversification. So it means that we have different people sharing their genes and making the next, hopefully the next person or the next child be stronger with some of those genes. That's why you have kids that are very good at sport and some which are very good at mathematics. We're all a little bit different. So here's just an example of how genes are spread and how they are mixed and matched. So you can see the grandparents have one child. And these two grandparents have another child. So that means if we count how many different type of genes we have. One, oh, let me make it black and bigger. So we have one, two, three, So four people share their genes with two people. And then these two people share again. These two people here share their genes with their kids. So if you look at that, for example, this one kid here, it's only, let's say this one, and this two, they have the same genes as four other people, but small amounts, only small amount. So the child has some of the information that has been given to him from the top to the bottom. So just to finish off here, the fractions that control and pass on inherited characteristics from parents and offspring are called genes. So that is the word we'll need to always remember, is the genes. Now, genes are located on chromosomes, which are present in every cell. And we also have two types, but those we get into next week, because otherwise it might get too long now. We have our dominant genes and our recessive genes. But those we'll talk about next week. So let's see who of you listened so far. What are we talking about? What are we talking about? You can tell me.
Team trees.
Again, please, a bit soft. Again, please. Can you say again, what are we talking about?
Family tree.
Ooh, right. Currently, we're speaking about the family tree and the genetic inheritance. Very big word. So, if we look back at everything we've done today, let's quickly have a look here. So, first, we looked at some words, but we looked mainly at how do we look at how, what determine how I look. If you stand in the mirror, in front of the mirror in the morning, and you ask yourself, why do I look like this? Then you have to also look at your parents, but also your grandparents and your great-grandparents. Because all of them, their gene or characteristic is inside you. Inside you. And usually, your grandparents' genes are stronger in your own body, in your own self, than your parents' genes are. So we talk about genetic inheritance. Big words here, let's just try and remember. Genetic inheritance, what I get from my parents is genetic inheritance. We also look at some characteristics which we can get. So being fat, being thin, being tall, being short, having light skin, having dark skin, having curly hair or nice, beautiful, straight hair. Some of us have earlobes which are very long, some which are very short, you know, different types of eyes, eye color, skin color. So a lot of differences we get every day. So that's why every human being and every one of you are also unique. You are different, and that makes you amazing because you are different and unique. Okay. All of us are a little bit different. So, let's see if anyone can tell me now, what did we talk about today? Hello? Who can tell me? What did we talk about? One sentence. We cannot play rock, paper, scissors until we have an answer. Until we have an answer. What did we what talk answer? About today? So my question is, what did we talk about today?
Family tree.
Yes, we talk about a family tree. Yes. And genes, yes. Chromosomes, characteristics, differences. Yes, very good. So at least some of us, I can see, you have listened today. Good job. If you know what we talk about, that makes me also excited. So if you want to play a little bit of rock, paper, scissors, now is the time to turn on your cameras. If you have not, it should actually be on the whole lesson, but yeah. Let's see if any of you can beat teacher in the morning. Are you guys excited? Let's see, how many do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We have 7. Hello, everyone. Are you guys ready? Did you guys warm up? Shake your hands, shake your heads. Think about what you're going to choose. And here we go. 1, 2, 3. Shoot. Oh, congratulations to Mobile, to Jasmine, to Panatat, to Aydin, and to Nam Nieng for beating teacher. Wow. It's only 2 of you that did not beat me. Oh, Leon, it's always difficult to beat teacher. Always struggle to beat the teacher. But congratulations to all of you that beat me. Yay. It's been a long time since a lot of you have beaten me.
Yeah.
Good job. Good job. So I think our class will end now in about 2 minutes. So I just want to let you guys know that after this, I will see you at 11 o'clock for occupation. And we can do something new in occupation, okay? So I hope you guys have a good day and I'll see you in a little bit. Bye-bye.
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 See you
later.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.